Have you done the program, the smallest program?
Yes, I tried my level best.
Okay, very good. So your thinking has started actually, I can easily observe. So the solution is very simple. You accept one number outside of loop, not in the loop, outside of loop.
Okay.
Outside of loop, you accept one number and store that number into small. Store that number into small. And remaining the n numbers you accept in loop. Then compare with small. That's it. Clear? Simple logic.
Yes, sir.
Right? Now we can do it. So any other doubts you are having?
Yes, sir, you told you will discuss those solutions, no?
Yeah.
The biggest of the two numbers without
right.
with using it.
Without using that one, right? And conditional operator, you got it? Biggest of three numbers without using conditional operator? Sorry, with the
both only I want.
Yeah.
No, sir.
Okay, it's very simple. Let me give a INT. This we are having INT. I'm writing small program. Biggest. I'm writing only the logic. Biggest of three numbers. Using conditional operator. Okay. N1, N2, N3. Then you can say big. So you can read the values into N1, N2, N3. I'm writing only part of the program, right? And N1, and N2, and N3. Once you read the values, then I want to find big. Since big equal to, if the value of n1 is greater than n2, and if the value of is n1 is greater than n3, then you return biggest value as n1. That's it. Condition.
Okay.
If n1 greater than n2 and n1 greater than n3, then you return n1. Else, compare n2 with n3. If condition is true, it will return n1 to big. It will store n1 into big. If false, if this condition is false, then it will go to else part. This is like your else part. Then you compare again n2 with n3. If n2 is greater than n3, then we return n2. Else we return n3. That's it. One line of code.
Okay.
That completes this. Right? Clear with this one?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Biggest of two numbers without using if condition and relational operators. Relational operators, okay? Again, N1, N2. Good. You can see now, scan it. %t, %t, and N1, comma, and N2. Then, now say switch N1 by N2. Switch off N1 by N2. Okay? So, if N1 is big, okay? Then, what is the quotient to be get?
If N1 is big,
the quotient will be any positive number. Let us suppose, let me take the example of this. I have taken 5 is the N1. And N2 is 10. Then if I divide N1 by N2, what's the value we get? 5 by 10?
1 by 2.
5 by 10 is what?
1 by 0.5, sir.
0, 0. Both are integers. Quotient.
Okay.
So when quotient. I divide a big smaller number with biggest number, the quotient will be always 0, right?
Yes.
Okay. So when I divide a biggest number, when I divide a small number with big, always the quotient will be 0. Okay,
yes.
Then if I say 15, then if I say 15 by 10, the quotient will be 1 or something, more than 1.
Okay.
Okay, so if it is case 0, case 0 means what? When I divide small with big, always the quotient will be 0. So you can say now, printf, big equal to %t, the value of n2, default. Default means any other value it is not 0, any other value means we can go with anything. That's it. Clear?
Yes, sir.
If it is 0 means n2 is big. If you are getting not 0, other number means n1 is big. Simple. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's the logic of this. So no conditional operator, sorry, no if condition and no relational operators.
Okay.
Okay. Now, we are discussing the while loop, right?
Yes.
So have you done this program, sum of even and sum of odd?
Sum of even or odd? Yes, sir, I sent you, no?
You have sent it, right? I did not remember that one exactly. Whether you have written correct or not, I did not remember. First one, you have, whatever you have sent is wrong actually. Then I ask you to go with 1 to 100.
Yes, sir.
That program I did not get it, yeah. Even odd.
No, sir. Again I did not send, sir. First one only, once starting I said.
Starting only, that is wrong I said. In sum of even numbers and odd numbers, you have to find sum of evens and odds 1 to 100.
Yes, sir, I tried. It is coming 5050.
5050? 5050 is for 1 to 100. We should get two outputs. Sum events, sum odds.
Yes, sir. Sum of events also it is coming 5050. Sum of odds also it is coming 5050.
5050. Okay. Okay. Let me write that program, right?
Okay.
Write a program to find sum of events and sum of odds from 1 to 100. Refer program. Sum even odd. Dot.
Sir, which school your children are studying, sir?
Yeah, they are studying in my first kid. Son is in second class. Daughter is in LKG.
Which school, sir?
Here in Chennanagar Academic Heights, Bachpan.
Oh, Bachpan, okay. Yeah.
Hash include stdio.h main function, int n, sum even equal to 0, sum odd equal to 0, initial values. Now say initial value of n, I am taking 1.
Okay.
While n less than or equal to 100. Why up to 100? Because we want to go up to 100.
Yes, sir.
Now take your number. No accepting values here. Just go to 1 to 100. So n plus plus. So this loop will repeat for 100 times. Now where the number is present in n. Now you check whether it is even or odd. How to check? If the value of n is divisible by 2, the remainder is 0. That means n is even. Then add that n to some even. Add that into some even. Else means what? N is odd. Then add that number to odd. That's it. That completes this.
Sir, this I had a doubt. I did this same thing only.
Okay.
I had a doubt. N plus plus. If we give it down, it will come in the else part. No, sir.
No. How it comes in else part? Because there are no curly braces. This statement does not belong to if else at all.
Ah, yes, yes, yes.
Right?
Correct.
So it is nowhere related to if condition. Because it's every number it will know. Okay, got it?
Yes, sir. That's, I was confused that n plus plus.
Okay. That's the reason when I am writing the code, observe it. When I start the begin n plus plus, I am saying. Because n plus plus is not related to if condition. It's like a repetition.
Yes.
compile and done, we get both answers directly. 2550 and 2500. Okay. Let us do one more example and very good example. That is, write a program to find sum of digits of a given number. Means, as an example, if I say number equal to 1 2 3 4, means sum of digits means 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, which results to 10. Okay. So, how to do this one? Let us understand. So if I take the number as 1, 2, 3, 4 and if I divide this number with 10, when I divide the number with 10, then what is the quotient here? 1, 2, 3, then 1, 2, 3, 0, then what's the remainder we get?
4.
What's the remainder? 4. So when I divide a number by 10, the remainder will be your last digit. Right?
Yes.
When you divide any number by 10, the remainder will be your last digit. Okay. See the logic. Yeah. So, let us suppose the number is 1, 2, 3, 4. Initial value of sum I am taking it as 0. Okay.
Yes.
Then, find the remainder. Remainder equal to n mod 10. So, what is the value of n?
N mod 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4 mod 10. What is 1, 2, 3, 4 mod 10?
Sum equal to sum plus r.
Very good. Sum equal to sum plus r. What are the remainder you are getting? Add it to sum. That's it. So which is 0 plus 4, which results to 4. Now the value of sum has become 4. Then next, which digit I should pull out? 3. So if I divide 1, 2, 3, 4 by 10, what is the quotient we got? 123.
4.
Right? 123.
Yeah, quotient. 123.
That quotient you put it again back into n. So make your n as n equal to n by 10. Means
yes.
1, 2, 3, 4 by 10, which gives 123. Now the number is what? 123. Now repeat the same steps.
Yes.
R equal to n mod 10. Now the value of n is 123 mod 10, which gives what? 3. So when you say mod, pull out the last digit. Okay. Then sum equal to sum plus r, which is 4, previous value of sum, and new value of r is 3, then which results to 7. N equal to n by 10. What is the value of n? 123 by 10, which results to 2. So when I say mod, you take out the last digit. When I say slash, remove the last digit. Okay?
Yes.
That way I can easily remember. Then I can repeat r equal to n mod 10. What's the value of n of 12? 12 mod 10 is what? 2.
1. 2. Okay.
2. 2. Last digit. Sum equal to sum plus r. 7 plus 2, 9, n equal to n by 10, 12 by 10 is 1.
Yes.
Repeat. R equal to n mod 10, which is 1 mod 10. What is 1 mod 10?
Sir?
1 mod 10?
1.
1. Okay. Sum equal to sum plus r, which is 9 plus 1, which is 10. Okay. N equal to n by 10. What is 1 by 10?
1 by 10. 0.
0. So we have to repeat these all steps until you reach n value as 0. When n becomes 0, then you display the value of sum. So how the loop should go now? If I take the n as 1, 2, 3, 4, initial value of sum as 0, then we have to check why n not equal to 0. So when n becomes 0, you have to terminate. When n is not equal to 0, you repeat these statements. What are the statements we have to repeat? R equal to n mod 10, sum equal to sum plus r, then
n equal to n
value. Clear? So first n value is what? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 not equal to 0, true. So these all statements will get executed. Okay, these statements will get executed. These statements.
Yes, sir.
So after this, what is the value of n now? 123. So 123 not equal to 0? Yes.
Yes.
Then again the statements will get repeated. So these statements will repeat. So once these statements are executed, now the value of n has become 12. Again 12 not
Yes.
equal to 0, yes. Then again these
Yes.
statements will get repeated. Now the value of n is 1. 1 not equal to 0, again true. Again these statements will get repeated. What's the value of n finally? So 0 not equal to 0, false, then comes. Okay. Then you print the final value of sum. What's the value of sum? Okay, which one? Right? That remember
Yes, sir.
the values. Okay. So
Yes,
let's
sir.
write this program. Refer program. Sum digit dots. I enter the number, initial value of sum is 0 and remainder. Accept the number first. Okay. Once you accept the number, now apply the logic while n not equal to 0. When n is not equal to 0, we add it. So always remember, whenever you want to pull out the digits, we have to apply this logic. R equal to n mod 10, sum equal to sum plus R, n equal to n by 10. Yeah. After the loop, you can say printf, sum of digits equal to the value of sum. Get save it. Sum digit dot c. When you compile and run the program, it will ask for the number. So I say 1, 2, 3, 4. What is the sum? Okay. What are the number it may be? It will take the sum of digits. Sorry. Okay. You take some other number and do the same process. We have written the program. Now you take the program. Take some other number and do these steps using program. Okay, using program do these steps. Then you can remember this how the flow is going. Okay. Let's go for the next one. Write a program to reverse a given number. To reverse a given number means if I say example, n is 123, then reverse should be what? 32.
Yes.
Okay, reverse means 3 to 1. Okay, then how to do this? Okay. Let me write the program and explain.
Yes.
Refer program. Reverse dot c. I enter the number and initial value of reverse we are taking 0. Accept the number. Okay. Now same while n not equal to 0 and the formula for reverse is reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus n mod n. You have to remember like a formula.
Yes.
Reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus n mod n and say n equal to n by 10. Okay, let me elaborate this.
Okay.
So if I take the number as 123, then initial value of reverse is what? 0, right?
Yes, sir.
While n not equal to 0, true. So that is 123 not equal to 0, true. Then formula is reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus n mod 10. Yes, n mod 10. Then what's the formula? What is the value we get? What is the value of initial revalue of liberty? 0. 0 into 10 plus
yes.
n mod 10, that is 123 mod 10, which is 0 plus 3. What is 123 mod 10? 0, 3.
Yes.
So now the final value is 0 plus 3, 3. Now what is the value of reverse now? 3. Okay?
3.
Okay. I get
yes,
n equal to n by 10. What is that 123 by 10, which goes to 12. Now the value of n is 12. Then I can repeat.
Yes, sir.
Reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus n mod 10. So, what is the value of reverse now? 3. We got previously.
3.
3 into 10 plus
12
mod 10, which is 30 plus 2. What is 12 mod 10? 2. So which is 32.
Okay.
Okay. N equal to n by 10, which is 12 by 10, which is 1. Then I can repeat. Reverse equal to reverse into 10 plus n
plus
mod 10,
mod,
which is 32. Reverse value is 32 into 10 plus 1 mod 10.
320 plus 1.
320 plus 1, which is 320.
Yes.
Okay, then n equal to n by 10, which is 1 by 10,
n equal to
what is 1 by 10? 0. So 0 not equal to 0 comes out. So final value of reverse is what? 3. Okay, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If I say 123, the reverse is 3. Any number you take, it will give the reverse of.
Yes.
Now let us go for one more and very good program, something realistic program. Like write a program to accept current balance. It's related to banking application. Write a program to accept current balance and display the following options. Display what? Following options. The options are 1, deposit, 2, withdraw, 3, display balance, 4, exit. So when I say deposit, what should happen? You should ask for the amount to deposit, right?
Yes.
When you want to deposit the amount, you should ask for the amount to deposit. Then what is the amount you are entering? That amount should be added to the previous balance, right?
Yes, sir.
Deposit means. Then when I say withdraw, again you should ask for the amount. And that amount should be subtracted from previous balance. Deposit should be added to previous balance. Withdraw means subtracted from previous balance. And display balance means you should display the what is the current balance now. And exit means comes out of withdraw. Means in this one, the menu should display repeatedly until the user uses exit. When I choose the exit option, then only it should come out of the program. Else, the menu should be keep on displaying to the user. Okay? Let us see how to do it. So when you want to repeat the code, put the code in loop, while loop. It's a menu driven, we make use of switch case. Okay?
Okay.
Let us see this.
Sir, we can use, we can do this using if also, no?
Yeah, we can even do using if also, but suggested to go with switch statement. For
okay.
menu driven, go with switch statement. Okay, because
okay.
If you say if ch equal to 1, again, do something, again else, again if, again ch equal to 2, the program looks bigger. When I apply switch,
okay.
The program looks small. Only that is it.
Okay.
Let us do this application.
Yes.
INT balance, the current balance which you want to, the balance which you want to store, and AMT is for what? Amount to deposit or withdraw, and CH variable is to accept the user choice. Then first of all, you accept the current balance. 10x percentage t and balance. So once you accept the balance, what we said, the menu should be displayed repeatedly. Means keep that menu in loop while 1. 1 indicates what? 1 means true.
Loop, yes.
1 means true. So this condition is always true. The condition is what? Always true. So we call this type of loops as infinite loops. We call this type of loops for infinite loops. Then, how to come out of loop? When I choose the option as 4, that is exit, then we'll come out of the program. In that way, we are coming even out of loop also. Then, in the menu, you display the options like printf, slash n, 1, deposit. So, without displaying the options, the user don't know what options he has to select. To withdraw. Okay, then once you display the menu to the user, ask for the choice.
Yes, sir. Enter your choice.
Enter choice. Then we'll store that choice into CH variable, that is use of CH. Then now you check. Switch off CH. The value what you entered in CH. Case 1. What is case 1?
Deposit.
So for deposit, we should ask for the amount. So I can give the message, printf, enter amount to deposit.
Yes, sir.
Then we'll say scanf percentage t and amount. So once we accept the amount, what we should do? Balance equal to? The formula is balance plus amount. Then amount should be added to the previous balance and put it again back into balance. Then break.
Yes, sir.
Then case 2. Yes. What is case 2?
Withdraw.
For withdraw also we should ask for the amount. Enter amount. To withdraw.
To withdraw. Scanf percentage and amount.
Scanf percentage t and amount. Now, can we withdraw the amount which is more than balance?
Minus.
Can we withdraw the amount which is more than balance?
No, sir.
No. So, you have to compare now. So, if the amount what I have entered is more than balance, then you can give the message, printf, balance is, okay, else. So, what is the meaning of else here? The amount is less than balance, then you can subtract that amount from balance.
Yes, sir.
Come out of loop by saying break. Sir, come out of switch by saying break. Please.
Sir, I am getting a phone call. 1 minute.
Okay,
sir.
Okay, you can attend.
Hello? Chapal? Yeah, I feel not interested. I'm already having class. I am already undergoing classes, thank you. Sir.
You are back,
sir.
Yeah, are you back?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
No, what is
urban?
Yes,
sir. I kept it in urban pronoun, sir.
Okay, okay.
For C++.
Okay, C++.
Still I'm getting, still I'm getting phone calls.
Okay, okay. Yeah, it will be, they'll be keep on coming. Okay, people will be
yes,
keep
sir.
On calling you.
Yes, sir.
Okay, they'll make a note of your number first. Then after that, they'll try to call you. That's the wrong way
yes,
of doing. So, until that time, some other will pick up you.
Yes, sir. Yeah, that's it, no?
Yeah, once the number comes to us, immediately we should catch the candidate. Else it will go to other
that
people.
I already am doing classes.
Okay. Right? So what is case 3 here? Display balance.
Yes.
You can see now. Printf. Current balance equal to percentage t, the value of balance. The value of balance.
Balance.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Then break. Then what is case 4? Exit. So how to come out of C language programs? Exit of what? We have already discussed in switch program, that addition subtraction program. Okay. So exit of one is used to come out of total program. So that completes this program. Then save it.
So default not necessary.
Yes.
Default, yes. Default.
Default? Not required, not compulsory. So even if you keep default, then it's you can say what again? Invalid choice.
Yeah, get CH.
Yeah, invalid choice.
Okay. No, sir, I'm telling get CH, you do not type.
Not required here, not required. Because however, you are in the loop, condition only. You are in the, still in, you are in the program. When I choose option 4 only, you will come out. So no issues for us. Let us see. Compile and run.
If you type also, no issue, sir. I can see, sir, no issue. No, no.
Yeah, I am unable to see properly. This is big program, no?
Okay.
Let me show you properly. So current, enter current balance, I am saying 5000. Now the menu has come. So 1 deposit, 2 withdraw, 3 display balance, 4 exit. So if I say 1, 1 indicates what here? Deposit. Then it is asking for the amount to deposit. So I am saying the amount again, something else say 7000. I am depositing what now? 7000. Then again the menu will come. Now if you check for the balance, what is the balance now?
13.
12,000, not 13. 7 plus 5.
Okay.
Okay, 12,000. Now I'll set 2.
Yeah.
2 indicates what again? Withdraw. So I want to withdraw 15,000. Is it possible?
No, sir.
No. So it is a balance is this. Again, I am saying 2, that is withdraw. Now I want to withdraw the money called as something around 8,000. We have withdrawn 8,000. Now if you check for the balance 3, now the balance will be 12 minus 8, 4,000.
Okay,
like that we can repeat until you want. Then when you want to come out, we will say exit. Then you will come out of the program. Clear?
Yes, sir. Right? ATMs work like this.
Yeah.
ATMs work with this process only.
Yeah. So this process means now it is web-based now. But internal logic is same thing as it is.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
So you are into which one? Specialization in BTEC?
I am finished first year, no sir. We are
okay.
In first year we have common subjects to all branches.
Right, right.
Still
you are having common subjects. So yes. yours is what specialization? Like IT or CS or electronics?
CSE, sir.
CSE. Then second year you'll be having Java.
Yes, sir. We have Java next semester. Coming.
Next semester. You can contact me because I am very much expert in Java rather than C. Because I do more of Java.
Okay.
C language I am doing only
okay.
2 batches every day now. It's only based
okay.
on request we do it.
Yes sir.
Okay, whereas Java we have done like anything. Like every day I will be having 8 batches only on Java technology.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay sir.
If you have taken the same Java course then you can find 5 to 6 people in the batch.
Okay sir.
And we won't promote C language actually because I am into Java technology. And we do
yes.
C language like if someone asks with less time and if I find some time, then I do it, C language.
Yes, sir.
Okay? So once
yes,
you enter into that Java, no? Or when you finish your college days in summer holidays, before
yes,
you enter
sir.
Into second year, you do Java. Then you can find lot
yes,
of difference in the college.
Okay.
Let us go for the next one. So these are the examples under while loop. Let us go with the do while loop. So do while loop is also for the same thing, repeating the statements continuously. And the syntax goes like this. Do, it's a keyword, then statements. Statement 1, statement 2, like this. Statement A. Okay. While condition. In the case of while loop, condition is checked before the statements, right?
Yes, sir.
But in the case of do while, condition is checked after the statements. So we'll see what is the advantage of checking the condition after the statements also. We'll see that. As an example, to print from 1 to 10, same thing. How to start? Int I equal to 1, then 2, then print the value of I, then go to the next number by saying I plus plus, until what time I should repeat? While I less than or equal to 10. Okay? So when I value becomes 11, it comes out. Same example. Let me document it. Difference between while loop and do while loop. Difference between what? While loop and do while. So in while loop, condition is checked before the statements. Right? In while loop, condition is checked before the statements. Whereas in do while loop, condition is checked after the statements. After the statements. Then, one more difference is, in the case of while loop, if the condition is false for the first time only. In the case of while loop, if the condition is false for the first time only. Then, how many times the statements will get executed?
If the condition is false.
For the first time only. First time only. So, will it enter into the statements? Not even once also, right? It won't enter into the statements at all. But in do while loop, if the condition is false for the first time only, in do while, condition is false for the first time only, but after executing the statements only, you are coming to condition. So, minimum one time the statements will get executed, right?
Yes.
Minimum one time it will execute the statements. After that only, you are coming to condition. Clear, Ishwan?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So, one more difference theoretically. The minimum number of times in while loop, number of times the statements are executed is 0, whereas in do while loop the minimum number of times the statements are executed is 1. Minimum one time it will execute. Okay, it's a theoretical discussion. Now let us see programmatically, in what situation do while loop is better than while loop? In what situation do while loop is better than while loop? Let us discuss. The situation is like, I want to find sum of given numbers. I want to find what? Sum of given numbers. How many numbers we are going to accept? No limit. No limit at all. No limit to accept the numbers. But when you want to stop, we'll enter the number as 0. When you want to stop, what we enter the number as 0. Okay, got the meaning of the program, what we want to do?
Yes, sir.
Right? So, let us do this program using while loop first. I'm writing only in the document. So, main int number and sum equal to 0 inch. Then, what is the condition when n is not equal to 0? You have to repeat. But when in n is 0, we should terminate. So, while n not equal to 0, the condition will become n not equal to 0. But, what is the value of n here? What's the value of n here? We did not accept any value. So, to know the n value, we have to accept n value outside. One time. So let us suppose I am saying 5 here. 5 not equal to 0, true. Then add that 5 to sum. Then in the loop accept the remaining numbers. Print f, enter a number, NF, percentage T and NF. Right? Then
Yes,
let
sir.
me say now 8. 8 not equal to 0, true. Then that 8 is added to previous sum, that is 5. 5 plus 8, it will become now 13. Now I'll say next number as 6. 6 not equal to 0, true. Then that 6 is added to previous sum, that is 13 plus 6, 19. Now I'll say the number as 0. 0 not equal to 0, false. Then comes out of while loop and say printf sum equal to percentage t, the value of sum. Clear? Which one? This one?
Yes, sir.
Right? Then let us do the same program using do value. So in the case of do value, directly we start do in the loop only we'll say printf entry number.
Yes, sir.
Then say scanf percentage t and n. Then once accept the number, add it to sum. Then you can say why. What is the condition? N not equal to 0. Same.
Yes, sir.
Printf sum equal to percentage t, the value of sum. Okay, same programs both are. But which program is less size? In while loop, which one contains less number of lines in the program? While loop
do
or
while
do value?
Loop. Do while loop.
Do while loop, right?
Yes, sir.
So in do while loop, the number of lines are less. So why? Because these two lines are additional in the case of while loop, right?
Yes, sir.
So since we don't know the value of condition here, we have accepted n value outside of loop. But in the case of do while loop, after accepting the number only, you are going to the condition. That's the reason these two statements are not required in the case of do while loop. So in what situation we have to use do while loop? When the value of condition, this is condition of, when the value of condition is known in the loop statements, you are accepting the value of condition in the loop only. After that, if you are going to condition, then in that case, go for do while. Else, remaining all the cases, either you can go with while loop or do. So what is the point you should remember here? If the value of condition is known in the loop statements, then it is suggested to use do while loop. Only suggestion, not rule.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Clear with this point now? When to think of do while? Right?
Yes, sir.
No. So that's the part for today. Then let me give some good assignments. Try to do this. Take 2 days time. Okay? Take 2 days time. If you are doing, no issues. Today only. By tomorrow, then no issues. Then maximum 2 days. Then I'll explain the programs to you. Okay?
Okay.
Write a program to check whether the given number is Armstrong or not. What is Armstrong? If I take the number as 371, then sum should be 3 cube. This is a symbol for cube. 3 cube plus,
yes, sir,
7 cube plus 1 cube should be again equal to 371. Means the sum of cube of every digit should be equal to the given number. Same sum of digits program only. Same sum of digits. Once you find the remainder, once you get the remainder, then go for what? Sum equal to sum plus, you have to find the cube. R into R. That's
R.
It.
Okay.
R cube. You have to add R cube to sum. So sum of cube of every digit equal to, should be sum equal to same given number. So if my sum value after the loop and given number both are same, means we have to say the number as Armstrong. Clear with the task? What you should do?
Yes. Yes.
Second one, write a program to check whether the given number is palindromorphic. So major part of program I have already done. Example, if I take the number as 121, then what's the value of reverse? 121, right? If our number and reverse are same, then we say it as what? Palindrome. Else will say not palindrome. Clear? If the given number and reverse are same, means palindrome. So already, I already have given the logic how to find reverse. So once you find reverse, compare your reverse with given number. If your reverse and given number are same, then we say it as palindrome. Else not palindrome. One more good one. Write a program to display the numbers from 1 to 100 which contains a digit 9. Then how the output should come? It contains a digit 9, means 9, 19, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, 39, you are becoming good in logical skills. Okay.
Yes, sir. Sir, this using any condition statement or only while?
Anything, we go with while loop only. Still up to now we have done while loop and do while loop. So try to use
Yes,
while
sir.
loop and do while loop. Suggest for all these
Yes.
programs, we suggest while loop and do while loop.
Okay.
Okay, anything is okay. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
In tomorrow's class, we'll be going
Okay.
with for loop. I'll discuss for loop.
2:30, no, sir.
Yeah, 2:30. Tomorrow it is 2:30.
Okay.
So you can use the same link to join the class. Same link.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So tomorrow 2:30
Okay.
and tomorrow we'll see for loop. Okay. Then after that we'll start out it. With that we close this one like what is it? Control statements. Control
Yes, sir.
statements. Okay, then we'll start up with arrays.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you very much.